like a bird out of prison, has taken his flight. Like a poet and God gave back his sight. Like a poor wretched beggar who found fortune and fame. I'm so glad that I found out he could bring me out with his lonely name.
Thank God I ain't free from this world of sin.
Sin I was living,
no thought was I giving of dying, where I would go.
I was looking in by,
so hard as I trying to gain all this world had to hold. No peace and no pleasure could I even measure with all that I had to gain. I repented and prayed, Christ saved me that day.
I'm not going to hell. I meant to say there was no hell.
He knows my name.
Stars one and all, he knows how much sand is on the shores, he sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the seas, he's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. And he knows my name, every step that
we're done after this, and I promise.
Are you past the point of weary? Is your burden laden heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? The shame that all is stealing, and the desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way when there ain't no say about my Jesus.
He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sin that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. When my Jesus
not very much, but Gregory's part will be touching in. Like I said, we're glad to be in the Lord's house this evening. Like I said, we appreciate everybody that's come out to be with us tonight. Didn't that youth choir do good? Amen. Amen. We're glad to see them doing something for the Lord. Amen. I'm glad to see how they're growing and continuing to serve the King. Amen. What a grand and glorious feeling it is to know that they are singing for Him. And what a grand and glorious feeling it is to be a child of the King. Amen. We always like to give everybody an opportunity to serve the Lord tonight. So maybe somebody else has a song on your heart, something you'd like to say or do for the Lord this evening. Hearts and minds are clear tonight. Then we're going to open our Bibles up over the book of Psalms, chapter number 40. If you was here this morning and you say deja vu, then that's right. Amen. A little deja vu. We're back in the same chapter that we were this morning. I intended to go somewhere else. But that's not what the Lord would have us to do this evening. So you pray for us. We just want to do that which God would have us to do. And if we do that, I know we're going to be where He wants us. Amen. And I know you'll get something out of it. We'll all get something out of it. When you find your place, would you please stand with us for the reading of God's Word? I shouldn't have to tell y'all that, y'all bunch of... Amen. Psalms chapter number 40. Psalms chapter number 40, and we're going to begin at verse number 5 this evening. Verse number 5, the Bible says, "Many, O Lord, my God, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done, and thy thoughts which are to usward. They cannot be reckoned upon in the order unto thee. If I would declare and speak of them, there are more than can be numbered." Let's pray. Dear me, Father, we come to you this evening, dear Lord, assembling ourselves before thee, thanking you for another day and another opportunity, God, just to gather out on this side of eternity. Lord, I thank you for loving us and caring for us and doing for us. God, when nobody else could and nobody else was able, God, you're able. We thank you for all the things that you've done in our life, dear God. I know, dear Lord, we thank you for the young choir. God, all those young folks that's willing to sing and do something for you. Lord, I pray tonight, dear God, you'll bless them along their journey, God. I pray, dear Lord, that you'll just give them guidance that'll help us guide them along the way. I pray, dear Heavenly Father, that you'll help them to stay strong serving you. Help them to stay in thy will. I pray, dear Heavenly Father, for all those on the prayer list, you know, every name and every burden, every heartache. God, only you can help. I pray, dear Lord, most of all tonight for those that are lost and undone. If there's anybody among us tonight, dear Lord, that does not know the free pardon of sin, I pray tonight, dear God, they would get in before it's everlasting too late. I pray now, Lord, you'll help us to take your word and open it up the way that you see fit. And Lord, if we don't get anything else out tonight, dear Lord, I pray that somebody will see a way to come to you. Lead, guide, and direct in the remainder of the service. Not our will be done, but thine. In Jesus' blessed name I pray. Amen. Amen. I was thinking with all the things and the events that's coming up and all the things that's happened here lately, look around us and we see all the things happening in our society. You know, we talk so much about the bad things that's happening, don't we? We spend a lot of time. I mean, you can't turn the news on. You can't see the world, hear anything about the world and not get disheartened. Amen? It's easy to get discouraged and downhearted in the day and the time that we live in. Amen? I mean, there's just so much wickedness and so much sin. There's just so many people getting further and further away from God. So many people have such little respect for God, have so little respect or courtesy, even thought of God. They don't even think about the Lord much anymore, because if they did, they'd be in His house, they'd be serving Him, they'd be trying to treat others right. Every week, there's no doubt that this week, that each of us are going to face some things that are going to just try to discourage us. Amen. That's going to try to get us in a downward state, to get us in a downward mood, to keep us from being happy. Bible tells us here in the book of Psalms, He tells us back over there in Psalms chapter number 1, He tells us over there that blessed is he whose God is Lord. or happy is he? We need to realize that the old devil does not want us to be happy. Amen. He wants us to think happiness is out there in the things of the world. He wants us to think that happiness is of the things that he has created. But I'm telling you, that's not it. So many bad things around. So many discouraging things happening. It's easy to stay there. As we preach this morning, the Bible tells us over there up in chapter 40 here in verse number 1, talks about being in a pit, talks about being in the miry clay. We preached this morning about the horrible pit and the pits that we fall into, the things in our life. A lot of times it seems like we stay in the pits, amen? But I'm glad to know that I've got a God that's able, like we preached this morning, not only to get us out of the pit, but I want to take a few moments this evening. I may not do anything but testify, amen? I may not do anything but just thank God this evening, because that's what I want to do. That's what David said. I spend so much time talking about the negative things of this world. I spend so much time thinking about how bad that we've got it sometimes. How bad, man, you know what? I've got to go home tonight. I've got to set that alarm early. I've got to get up in the morning. I've got to travel to Knoxville. All these bad things I've got to do. Amen. But here's what David said. David had been out there in the pit. And I want you to get a glimpse of just where David had been. David had been in a battle in his life. Amen. David was in the middle of a battle. He'd had things happening all around him. He'd been in situations where Saul wanted to kill him. He'd been in situations where the people loved him. Now he was in a situation where they hated him. And now he had been in that place where enemy was all around him and trying to destroy him. But here's what David had to say. David had to say, he looked up toward heaven. All these bad things going on around him. David said, listen, I've been blessed of God. If I was to start to number the things that God has done for me, I could not even begin to count them up. That's what I want to do this evening. I just want to testify a little bit of how good God's been. God's been good in my life. Sure, I've seen troubles. Sure, I've had heartaches, but the good far outweighs the bad. Beth told you this morning, there's been many times that I've been down and out, but I've never been left of God. He's always been right there with me. Listen, I could have been born in some foreign country. I could have been born in some third world country over there, maybe never heard of God, barely even knowed anything about him. But you want to know what? I was born in a country, where the gospel is free. I've been born in a place where I can still get up and come down to an old-fashioned Baptist church, and hear about Jesus. I'm glad that I've been blessed above a measure. What he said? He said, I've been blessed above measure. Amen. Have you ever thought about it? Have you ever thought about what being blessed above measure means? Being blessed above measure means, there's things that you can measure. There's things that you can size up. There's things that you can get a measurement on. But the things that God does for us each and every day, we can't even measure that. We can't even begin. You say, well, listen, I'm in a bad spot, preacher. You don't know what. Listen, I do know this. I know that you've got air in your lungs, amen? If you didn't have air in your lungs, you'd be gasping. You'd be passed out. You want to know who did that? God did that. I'm glad I live in a place right now. I'm able to be able to come in, and I'm able to breathe fresh air in. And I'm able to lift up my eyes. Why? Because God got me up out of the bed this morning. God got me up and out this evening. You want to know how we got here? I doubt any of you walked or rode a horse or was drug. We all got in our automobiles and we come down to the house of God, sat on padded pews in the air, heating and air conditioning. I'm glad that I'm in America where God has blessed. Amen. I'm glad I live in a country where men and women have given their lives to die for us. Given their lives that we might have the freedoms that we have today. I'm glad that we live here. God's still good. Amen. Listen, I'm ashamed of some of the things that we do in our government. I'm ashamed of some of the way that they act. I'm ashamed of some of the things that they say. I'm definitely ashamed of some of the bills and things that they have passed. But I can still say this. Even though this world is going the wrong way, even though this world is headed to hell as fast as it can go, I'm still glad that I live in a country that I can get up and have the freedom to be able to get up and preach the Word of God. Listen, I don't know that this will last very long. I don't know that it'll last very long that we won't get put in jail and other things for preaching the gospel. But I'm still blessed. Amen. Listen, I look around and I see some of these countries and I see some of the things that are going on. I'm glad to know today that I'm still blessed. Amen. Those things, we look around and we see war and rumors of war. We see talks and things that's going on. God told us that in the end times, there'll be wars and there'll be rumors of wars. Hey, that's all we hear anymore. That's all we hear talk about. There'll be pestilences and there'll be earthquakes in diverse places. Hey, I tell you what, I've heard all of it. I've saw all of it. I know the end time is coming. Bible tells us over in the book of 2 Timothy chapter number 3 that in the last days there shall be perilous times. In the last days men will be lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. He tells us that they're going to believe all kinds of doctrines. They're going to believe everything under the sun. And they look up because you're the Redeemer drawing nigh. Hey, I know I'm living in the last days. I know it's perilous times, but I'd still have to say that God's still good. Amen. He's still good. I wouldn't throw him back, would you? I wouldn't give up on him. He's brought me this far. Amen. I've made it through a lot of rough spells. I've made it through a lot of rough times. All because of God. I look around and I see some of these churches and I see how they're doing. I see the way they're going. I've had people talk to me about things in their church and things going on at their places. Hey, from the sounds of some of them, hey, you wouldn't know the difference between them and some rock concert or some bar or some concert out in the world. Hey, you are more about show than they are about God. I'm glad I've still been blessed. Hey, to be able to come up the Heavenly Light Baptist Church, hey, to be able to pastor a bunch of people, hey, that want to serve God. Hey, I tell you now, we got a bunch of young folks that ain't ashamed to get up there in that choir and sing for God. I'm just waiting to see how God uses them and God blesses them. Hey, you know what? It wasn't always an easy road. It wasn't always an easy thing. Hey, you say, well, listen, what do you mean? Hey, I remember just like it was yesterday. Hey, when our church didn't have that many in it, I remember when there wasn't but 3 or 4, and God put it on a man's heart, hey, to take them downstairs and start something. Hey, let me tell you what happened. You look up there and see this evening what happened. Hey, he put it on some others' hearts, hey, to start doing other things and taking them out. Hey, I'm here to tell you, you'll never outdo God. I'm here tonight to say, I'm just glad that God's still blessing. I couldn't count them, son. I get out of the bed in the morning. I love this song. Y'all might have to consider singing it. When I wake up in the morning, till I lay my head to rest, I am blessed. I am blessed. Listen, there ain't a day, ain't a day that I get up. There ain't a day that I go to bed, that everywhere in between those times and even after, while I sleep and while I'm awake, God still blessing. Hey, God's been good to me. Amen. I look out there and I can go back through my y'all know my testimony. I can go back through my life and I can see so many things where I should have given up. I see so many places where God should have given up, where God should have just said, that's it. I'm done fooling with him. There's another old song that says this. Hey, about going to God and God saying, I'm done with you. I'm done fooling with you. I'm done patching you up. I'm done picking you up. I'm done cleaning you up. Well, you know what? That's all a bunch of lies, because God comes by every day to make sure that we have what we need. What a place. What a place. I've been blessed. I've been blessed. Look, I told Melissa, we was talking the other day. We had the boys for all week long. Listen, when they told us they was going out of town and we was going to keep the boys, here's what I want to say. Man, I don't know that I was really looking forward to it. I love my grandkids. I do. But Melissa and I have got used to being empty nesters. Amen. Melissa and I, when Friday rolled around, we weren't necessarily ready for them to go home. Hey, man, we had a great week. We had a week. Man, listen, now look, it amazed me at this how God, and I look back, I told Melissa, I said, you know, you remember back when we got married and didn't hardly have enough money to even get the water turned on. Hey, you know what? Those days and times and hours, I said, you remember back? Hey, when we had more month than we had money, you remember back when we didn't know how we was going to make it? You remember back when we had to pick and choose what we was going to get at the grocery store? You remember back, hey, all the times and all the jobs that we had? I remember back when I had to put gravel in the driveway. I had to wait from the tar and chat the road. Hey, after about a week or two and all the gravel was in the curves, hey, and go shovel up enough gravel just to patch a whole pothole in the driveway. Hey, I remember back to all those things. I can see where I'm at today, and all I can do is just like David, look up and say, without measure, Lord, you have been blessed, still blessed. Amen. Every day I look up, I can just talk to God and say, Lord, I want to thank you. I know that I've had suffered loss. I know that I've had some heartaches and hard times. Listen, I look back in our life and I see sickness that rolled into our families. I'll never forget this. I remember my mom passed away with a heart attack. She mowed grass on Thursday night, and on Friday morning she passed away with a heart attack. And I know it was out of sudden, it was heartache, and it was troublesome. But we got through it. And I tell you what, I was thinking that it wasn't too long after that. Melissa's dad had been battling cancer for years and years. We was down at Myrtle Beach. I believe that's where we was. She got that call about having, you need to get home, and you need to get home now. Don't know if he's going to make it. And I remember coming up the road, and I was thinking about how many times that I saw that very same look on my wife's face. I don't know how many times they called the family in. I don't know how many times, hey, that they called them and said, look, this is just, we're pretty sure that this is it. But you know what I can say? I can say through it all, God's still good. Hey, I can remember, I've got a video on my phone. I've got messages on my phone of my father-in-law preaching. But there's a video of him sitting there in the kitchen right before he died. Here he'd been battling cancer year after year, day after day, hour after hour. You want to know what he was talking about that last few moments? He was talking about still blessed. Hey, God, God's been good. I can tell you today, you'll not find anything like him. You'll not find anyone that can outdo him. And you'll not be able to measure all that he does. Amen. You'll not be able to measure all that he does. What a God we serve. What a God we have. And David said, my Lord, many, O my Lord, my God, are thy wonderful works. Many, many, many. I wonder how many times we've had sickness roll into our life. I wonder how many times you've had sickness roll into your family. But God's still been good. God's still been good. I wonder how many times that you felt like you wasn't even going to be able to make the light payment. I wonder how many times you wasn't going to even be able to make the bills that month. And all of a sudden, here we sat tonight, still blessed. Still blessed. Hey, I wonder how many times that life has come and thrown obstacles in our way. We've had to suffer the loss of loved ones. We've had to see through the things that death has brought our way. Here's what I want to say tonight. We've talked, Melissa and I, since a lot of things has happened in our church and in our family the last little bit. We've talked more about death, I guess, in the last month than we have in a long time. Talking about preparing things earthly, but here's what I want to say. Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. I don't want to leave right now. There's a lot of things I'd like to see accomplished. There's a lot of people I'd like to see saved. There's a lot of people I'd like to see serving God with everything in them. But here's what I will make you a promise of. When I leave out of this place, don't fret for me. Don't cry. Cried more, because I promise you, I'm in a lot better place. I'm over there with my Heavenly Father, walking down the streets of gold. Hey, over there where there's no more pain, still blessed. Amen. If I go or if I stay, I'm a winner either way. That don't mean hurtful things ain't gonna happen. That don't mean the devil is not going to do everything he can to destroy. Look, I know how life is. The devil would like to destroy families. He'd like to get in there and rip things apart, make your marriage upside down, make your family upside down. The devil would like to do it all. But here's what I want to tell you. Don't make it easy for him. Don't make it easy for the devil to get into your family. What do I mean by that? That means be like David. Wait patiently upon the Lord. And to remember this, that in everything, God still good. In everything, in every phase that you have to go through, every step that you have to take, every mile that you have to walk, remember that God is still good. He'll give you the strength to make it up the next mountain. He'll give you the strength to get across the next hill. He'll give you the strength to get across the next river. Hey, I'm telling you, what God has got for us is far more than what this world has. And what God has for me tomorrow, he already knows about it. They might be a pit for me to fall in, but if I'll listen to God, he'll know how to establish my goals. You know what's not even better than knowing that God's still good is to know this. I know when I look at my life and I look at my past that God's been good. When I look in my life right now in the present, I know that God's still good. But I also know this, that tomorrow, if tomorrow comes, if the Lord allows me to go to sleep tonight and to wake up tomorrow, if I wake up in the morning when that alarm clock goes off, I may not like it, I may not care much for it, but I can tell you this much, God will be good tomorrow. Amen. God will be good tomorrow. Just like he was good, just like he is good, he sure will be good. God knows what's in the future. He knows what he holds for me. I don't want to leave out tonight, and I don't want to leave out tomorrow without holding to his hand, his unchanging hand. I want to get a hold of it, and I want to walk close to him every day. How about you? Every head bowed, every eye closed, every Christian praying, every heart searching. ask you tonight, how is it with you? Is God good in your life? Do you realize just how good God is to you? David said they're above measure. Can't even measure them. Can't even measure. Listen. God knows. God knows where you are. God knows what you're going through. He knows what your family struggles are. He knows what your heartaches are. He knows what your burdens are. Would you just be honest? Do you need Him tonight? Do you need more Jesus? Do you need more of the Lord? Has God been good to you? How about thanking Him tonight? I want you to know tonight, I usually ask a lot of questions. I usually ask a lot for hands to be raised. I'm not going to do that tonight. I want you to know tonight that this altar is open for anyone, for any reason. If there's something you need to pray about, somebody you need to pray for, or you just want to come up here on this altar, and you just want to come down here and not pray for anything, but just to thank God for being so good. Thank God for being so good. It's open for anyone for any reason right now. I'm going to put myself on this altar, and I just want to thank Him for all the things that He's brought me through. I want to thank Him for all the things He's kept me from. And I want to thank Him for what He's going to do tomorrow. Anybody else want to come before we pray tonight? She's going to finish up playing right here, and we're going to go to the Lord in prayer. I hope tonight, if He comes knocking for you, He comes beating your door down. Are you ready? Are you ready? Anybody else want to come before we pray? All right, okay. Amen. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Jason, you pray for us.